Go.
In this demonstration, I'm going to show you how to roll film onto a processing reel. I'm going to use a steel processing reel, and this is a 35 millimeter processing reel. It's the kind of reel you use 35 millimeter film on, in this case, black and white film. I'm not here to endorse particular products, but this reel is a Hughes brand reel, H-E-W-E-S, and I do find that Hughes reels are much easier to roll on than less expensive products. The metal, the gauge of the metal is wider, and it just has a better anchoring system. So that's what I'll be using. So first we need to open our film. Keep in mind that everything I'm doing in this demonstration, you will do in absolute darkness, either in a completely dark room with no safe light, or using a changing bag or something like that. So to pry open the film cassette, you want to take the lid off on the flat side, not on the side with the spool sticking through. I'm going to use a can opener with two little prongs on it, and you can use a regular can opener too if you want, and I'm just going to pry off. It was harder to pry off than they normally are, I don't know why. Once you have the film off, you set the can opener aside, and then slide the film with its interior spool out of the cassette, the shell of the cassette, and discard that. So now, again, in the dark, you need to cut the leader off the film. So I usually lay my right index finger along the back side as a way to guide the scissors. And I try to use smaller scissors, like children's scissors, if I'm using a changing bag, because it helps me make sure I'm not going to cut the bag. So I can lie that across my finger and cut a nice straight line, which will help me roll. Now I usually check this with my finger to see if I've cut through any of the sprocket holes, and if there's a kind of a jagged edge there, I'll take another cut until I have a nice smooth edge like that. All right, now I'm going to pick up the reel, and the reel is one coil of metal, or two coils of metal for both sides, and when you roll it onto the reel, what this does is it prevents the film from touching itself in any way, and it allows all the chemistry, the liquid chemistry, to flow through and evenly develop your film. So it's very important to get it onto the reel properly. So I hold my film in my right hand and the reel in my left hand, and I have the coil coming off towards the reel on the film, and I have the coil of the reel coming off towards the film. Not like that. They can't be going the same way. They have to be going towards each other when they're at the top. So it doesn't mean I'm always going to have it at the top, but when it comes to the top, that's the position I want it to be in. Now, if you can see in here, there are two little teeth right there and there, or more like fangs, really. So they're sticking out there and there. That's important to note when you're getting ready to roll the film. So what I do is I hold the film in such a, or hold the reel in such a way that I put my thumb in the space right above and behind those two fangs. So I'm going to end up putting the film into this space, this nice big space, but it's dark, so I won't be able to see that. So I put my thumb there, and that's how I hold the reel. Now I have to pull out a little bit of film and bend it in just slightly so that it can reach inside here. Now, if you don't hold out enough, you can't get it in. If you hold out too much, that's what happens. So you have to find just the sweet spot of how much film to extend. So in the dark, I've got my thumb in that space, and now I insert the film in, and I can knock the film into my thumb, and I can feel that, so I know I'm in the right space. So when I have it right in the right space, touching my thumb, then I slowly remove my thumb and use my thumb to help guide the film into that big space. Now the next step is critical. I want to pull the film down at a sharp angle so that the fangs or the teeth engage two sprocket holes. Hopefully you can see that there. And that's going to anchor it evenly. Now, usually I'll set the reel down, but before I do that, I like to do my first couple of turns with the film angling very far down. So it's going up into the reel like this. Not like this, but like this. So I'll gently roll the reel like that. Okay, so once I get started and everything's going okay, I'm going to keep a gentle bow here to guide the film into the reel, and I'm going to keep my finger and my thumb close to the reel. I'm not going to be over here because that's going to make a problem. So I'm just going to stay right there, and I'm going to let the action of rolling the reel take the film up. And all the time I'm doing this, I'm listening, and it should be a nice, smooth, kind of shushing noise. If I hear a pop or a crackle or something, or if I feel what seems to be the film jutting off to the side, then I know I have made a mistake, and I can back up past that point and just gently try to lay it down again. So there's no hurry. You really kind of want to get into a Zen state when you do this. Sort of, you know, be in a peaceful state of mind. If you get anxious about it, you'll find that you're more likely to damage the film. And then once you've damaged the film, it's very hard to roll onto the reel. So it's going nice like this. And then there's a couple of ways where you can, a couple of ways for you to confirm whether you're doing it right. One happens about midway through. You're midway through, if you do this, there should be some play. It should move like that a little bit as you go back and forth. If there's not, it means that the film is bound up somewhere on the steel reel and it won't move. If it doesn't move at all, there's probably a problem and you should back up. Then you continue going. Once you get in a groove, it doesn't take long at all. The next confirmation you have that you've done it right is that a roll of 36 exposure film, roll of 36 exposure film should take up the whole reel. I'm working with a roll of 24 exposure film, so I expect it to end right around here. But if it ends here and you're rolling 36 exposures, you have a problem because it's doubled up somewhere. So a 24 exposure roll can stop here, 36 should be on the end. One more check when you're done is to run your hands across both sides of the reel. And if there's a problem, you normally will feel a peak of film sticking out, like a high point. And there's nothing like that here. So once you have it rolled in the dark, you just want to cut close to the spool and then just lay that tail down like so. Then, of course, you want to put it into your processing tank and you want to put your processing lid and cap on there and seal it so it's light safe. Now, once you've sacrificed a roll of film in order to practice this, you can always take it off and reuse it as a practice film, because you really don't want to jump into processing film until you're confident that you can roll the film properly. And that means that you can do it several times without any mistakes. So practice in the light, and then dim the lights and practice, and then turn the lights off completely and continue to practice, and you should be okay. All right, thanks very much.